Now we're going to look at two examples of dividing a polynomial by a binomial, or more specifically, a degree 2 trinomial divided by a degree 1 binomial. And we're going to use the method of long division. And since a fraction bar represents division, we can write this as x squared minus 5x plus 7 divided by x minus 2. X squared minus 5x plus 7 is called the dividend, and these terms must be in descending order, meaning from highest degree to lowest degree, which they are, and the same thing for x minus 2, which is the divisor. And our answer will be the quotient. Now, there's a couple ways to start this division process, but we are only concerned about the first term of the dividend and the first term of the divisor. One way to determine the first term of the quotient is to ask, what times this x would be equal to x squared. So if we know x times x would equal x squared, the first term of our quotient will be x. However, this is a division problem, so another way to determine this first term would be to take x squared and divide by x. And notice that x squared divided by x would also equal x, our first term. Now once we have this x here, we're going to multiply it with the divisor and then put it below. So we have x times x, that would be x squared. And then x times negative 2 would be negative 2x. So we have minus 2x. And then when performing long division, we need to subtract this result. But instead of subtracting this binomial, it's often much easier to just add the opposite. So we can change this to addition as long as we change the sign of each of the terms inside the parentheses. So we can change this to addition as long as we change this to a negative x squared, and this would become plus 2x. Notice how here we have x squared plus negative x squared, that's 0. And when we do this, the first term should always be opposite, so we have a sum of 0. And then we have negative 5x plus 2x, that's going to be negative 3x. And then we bring down the next term, plus 7. And now we're only concerned about the first term of the divisor and the first term of this result. And again, there's a couple ways to find the next term. We can ask ourselves, what times x would be equal to negative 3x? If we know that would be negative 3, we can go ahead and put minus 3 up here. Or, since this is a division problem, we could take the term negative 3x and divide by x. And notice how that also gives us the next term of negative 3. And now we're going to multiply negative 3 and the divisor. So I have negative 3 times x, that's negative 3x. Negative 3 times negative 2 is positive 6, so we have plus 6. And again, we need to subtract this. But instead of subtracting this, we're going to add the opposite. So we'll change this sign to addition, change this negative to a positive, and change this 6 to a negative. Again, notice how the first terms, we have the sum of opposites. So this would be 0. And then we have 7 plus negative 6, that's positive 1. We've used all the terms, which means this is the remainder. When performing long division with polynomials, since this remainder is positive, we're going to have plus the remainder over the divisor of x minus 2. So this quotient is equal to x minus 3 plus 1 over x minus 2. One more thing to mention in this example, since there is a remainder, x minus 2 does not divide evenly into x squared minus 5x plus 7, and therefore x minus 2 is not a factor of this trinomial. Looking at our second example, again, since a fraction bar represents division, we can write this as x squared plus 8x plus 12 divided by x plus 2. And again, to start, we're only concerned about the first term of the divisor and the first term of the dividend. So again, there's two ways to determine the first term of our quotient. We can ask what times this x would be equal to x squared. If we know that would be x, we can put an x up here. The other way is to take x squared and divide it by x, which is also equal to x, giving us our first term. Now we're going to multiply x and our divisor. So we have x times x, that would be x squared. x times 2, that's plus 2x. And we're supposed to subtract this. And instead of subtracting this, we're going to add the opposite. So we'll change the sign here to plus, change this to a negative, and change this to a negative as well. X squared plus negative x squared is 0, and then 8 plus negative 2x would be 6x. Bring down the next term, plus 12. And now we're only concerned about the x of the divisor and the 6x of this result. So we want to know x times what would be equal to 6x. That would be positive 6, so we have plus 6. Or the alternative would be to take 6x and divide by x, which would also give us 6. And now we're going to multiply 6 in the divisor, so that would be 6x plus 6 times 2 is 12. And we need to subtract this. But instead, we're going to add the opposite. So we'll change this to addition, change the sign here, and change the sign here. So we have 6x plus negative 6x, that's 0. And we also have 12 plus negative 12, that's also 0. So here the remainder is equal to 0. So our quotient is x plus 6. Because the remainder is 0, we can say x plus 2 divides evenly into x squared plus 8x plus 12. And therefore, x plus 2 is a factor of our trinomial. Okay, we'll be looking at several more examples of long division in the next few videos. I hope you found this helpful.